Hello friends, and welcome again to my channel. And today again I'm going to try out a bit critical still life. So you can see kitchen utensils are there, and there is an Indian chulha, okay, furnace. So let's try it out with a sketchy style. So I'll be using the composition like this. So I'm going to change it a bit. So here is a पॉट, यहाँ एक पॉट है. मैं स्केची वे में जाऊंगा, ज्यादा डिटेल नहीं, सो दैट द प्रेशर कुकर एक है, इसका सीटी है, इट्स ऑलमोस्ट इन सेंटर. ज़्यादा डिटेल में नहीं करूँगा, ट्राई कर रहा हूँ स्केच जैसा ही रखने का, देखता हूँ. आउटलाइंस थोड़ा सा फोकस. So let's erase it. और ये थोड़ा सा छोटा लेटर ऑन टेलीग्राफ आइडिया मिल जाए. आइडिया मिल गया, इतना दूर ब्लॉक है और थोड़ा सा एंगल थोड़ा लंबा मैं बनाऊंगा, इसको देखने में अच्छा लगेगा. इट विल लुक गुड अ बिट. थोड़ा सा मैं लंबा कर देता हूँ, इतना दूर. ये जो है थोड़ा सा छोटा कलर करते समय कुछ और चेंजेस होंगे. जैसा है, there's a stand I can see and a shadow, and here also I can see the more smaller size little bit. So I'll be taking these only the three things. So that's it. This quickly I'm going to leave. So the three things I have drawn here, the sketch, and let's give this. I'll not go into much detail here. We'll be putting some sort of lines and strokes. So this is the sketch, and here I can change the color. using this element. That's it. So let's start. So here is the drawing. Now let's start applying colors. So for this, let us wet the colors first. ऐसा करने से क्या होता है, कलर इजीली ब्रश में आ जाता है. सो आई एम यूजिंग हियर अगेन चार्ट पेपर वाटर साइज एंड कैमल आर्टिस्ट्स कलर. मैं बोलता जाऊंगा मैं कौन सा कलर कब यूज कर रहा हूं. और फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर न्यू इन माय चैनल, डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब एंड हिट द बेल आइकन फॉर रेगुलर अपडेट्स. सो let's start from, you know, the elements itself. So here I'll be using a bit smaller brush, this round brush, and I'll start. I can see, you know, some orangish color, bluish color. So I'll start with blue, lighter blue, like this. Want to give a flat wash actually, simply. And then on the same wet area I'll be using orange also, so as to get a blend effect. Here I'll be using again blend for blending purpose. I'll be using yellow ochre mixed with a bit of red just over it to get, you know, a more bland feel. Now of color, in certain areas I'll be using it like this. So this will be my highlighted area, and the same color I'm going to use on the pressure cooker also, just to, you know, get a nicer feel. Line I can show here, and I'll be blending it because it came very much darker. So let's wipe it out a bit like this. And the same color I'll be using yellow ochre again with a bit of vermilion on this area. And we'll try to keep, you know, I'm using here again gamboge yellow for a highlighted, you know, showing a lighter value here. And I can see varieties of colors, so I'll be using the same. I'm going to use brown, green by mixing viridian with yellow ochre here in this area, and try to leave, you know, the topmost area white. Just want to get a blend effect here. And the same area I'll be using a bit of chrome yellow here to get a different color, just like this. And the same time I'll be using cobalt blue here. Same time I'm using cobalt blue, and again gamboge yellow on that blue, just to get a greenish value. And on this side I'll be using Russian blue, and sorry, I don't have Russian blue, so I'm using ultramarine blue on this side, so to get a darker value. And what I'm trying to blend all the colors with each other, so using wet on wet here, just to get, you know, a blend effect like this. And let's wipe out some extra amount of colors here from here, so as to, I can show, you know, some smokes later on. I'll be showing some smokes here, so wiping for that only. Let's blend this white. Actually it isn't, I don't think it's required here. Give some short strokes here. So now I can use, you know, some brownies or purple color for getting extra darker value along with black. Generate a greater value here like this. Just want a greater value in this side like this. It's almost wet, and I'll be changing this sort of color along with brown on the bottom side. Wet on wet I'm applying colors here, and same color I'd like to go with this side also. As the area is still wet, I can use that wet surface. So here I can create a field, and on the bottom I'll be using a dark line only here. Just to generate, greater value. So here, just blend certain areas, and then we're just taking water only to drag, this area like this. Just to get a blend effect. So, I think it's almost done. So let's use a bit of more value here. I can see a greater value here, so I'll be using the same. And again I will be taking water only and scroll dry brush using the bristles like this. So this will create nicer feel of some lines also, as well as some stroke works, means a speed feel. So now let's come to this. Again, I'll be using gamboge yellow here, and we'll be changing colors also like this. Now we'll move on with the different color. I'll go with again blue this way, this side. I'll try to change the color also. I'll take water. I want a bit lighter tone here. So again, take an off color. Just let me use some straight strokes like this. Let's blend this with yellow. Just want to blend the red, so I'm mixing it. And on the bottom, I'll be using a greater value. Means that blue is black or purple, I can make just here. Just to create an aluminium effect, actually, I'm doing it like this. So, I'll be using a bigger effect like this. Go for the tone. Instead of doing a lot of details, we can do like this. Go for sketches which will create, you know, a good amount of. So I will be changing your color again. Keep on changing color. This is my suggestion, just to make it dynamic. And this way. So let's increase darker value here. So as to create a shadow. Here I'm using show shadow. Now here I'll be using a small brush, fine brush in this place. Some dots I can show. So in this way we can move. I got three things, three elements, and let's use. Try to draw this top. Most of the work will be done, you know, while using the background. So I'll try that. Almost I'll be using a fine brush to make the handle. So for that I need a pointed brush, and I'll be making orange color because I can see here a bit of orange. And I'll be using lighter. Again, I'll be using only yellow to move ahead. I can see here a bit yellow white stone. So here I think I'm done. Now let's use a darker value here. And I'll be using more blackish tone here. Just to show the handle. Let's see. Very darker value here. That's it. And later on, I can use different color also. So is the handle I have got. So now let's come to the fire area, but before it I'll be using, you know, some very bold strokes here. Means flat color of yellow ochre, and I have taken a huge brush here of almost 2.5 inches. So I'm preparing a color. And I'll be using this brush. I'm using first time, so let's see how it will come, whether it's going to help me or not. I don't know. That's a good brush. I can feel. I can use again a bit of greater value on the bottom side. like this. Just a lighter area I left, leave, and now I can go for some. Let's distribute the color on the top also. Let's come to this. So I'll be using just to source more here. I'm using a bit of cobalt blue here. And some brighter colors, since I'll be using some brighter color I'll be using. For this I'm taking orange color I'm trying to create, and a bit of yellow also, just to show a bit of fire like. And we'll go with some red also in certain areas like this. The color of fire, yellow is reddish or kind of that. Suggestive. Not going for too much detail. I'll be using direct crimson also in some areas like this, just for suggestion. I'm using it for the suggester, you know, fire. So now let's use darker value. For that I'll be using again fine brush. Is the fine brush, I don't know. And I'll be using that purple blue color along with a blackish tone. I'm mixing black also, ultramarine, crimson, and black to generate, you know, a greater amount of color here. Just want to increase, you know, some. I'll be using again, I'll be changing some sort of color here. I'll be using brown, black, red, light colors. So, here is the point of interest. I'm not going for too much detail here. let's use a bit of brownish tone. Create a volume here. I'll be using a bit yellow for this orange color. So it should be quite related. So. Okay. Like this. It's so hard. Again, I'll be preparing some yellowish orange color. Just create more. Like this. Just I've tried to create a volume of, you know, for such a new volume. Just using wet and wet to just generate, you know, the feel. Now let's go to the background. I'll be changing color here. So, let's go for the background. For that I'll be using a flat brush and we'll start with, you know, the blue, the same like this, and we'll use Veridian along with the just taking care of the shape. Show you the image once again. Let's increase the darkness. Again, I'll be using blue, green, and black here. Using flat brush actually can cover up most of the areas. That's why I'm using it without, you know, leaving too much. Keep on changing colors. That is what I'm trying here. I'll be taking care of the shape. use black also. Let's again change the value to use green blue both. Just taking care of the shape here. Out like this, very much more darker values there. That's what I'm trying to show. Just compare the darkness, always try to compare. So from there you will be getting, you know, the values. You have to play with the values, which is very important. Here I think I have got the dimension. Creating contrast is much more essential. Here I'll be using again a bluish tone. And the greenish tone as well. And what I will do here, I will just take a tissue paper and we will try to, you know, just remove like this, so as to get, you know, a smooth light feel. Just smoke, just to create a smoke. Here I will be just wetting the paper like this. And again, the tissue paper I'll be using, just, you know, get smoke kind of feel. So this is, I've got the effect. Now let's increase the value. In certain areas I'll be increasing the value. Here you can see. Try to keep on changing the colors. That is what I recommend. Again, I will be changing the color. The area is wet. Keep on changing the color. Now let's use a smaller brush. Go for the detail. and I'll be mixing with black on this time. And we'll do the bottom side. Just like this. See the shadows, the darker values here. See the value. Now let's use again a different color, okay. Some greenish on this side. Show you know a kind of shadow. So that's it. I'm almost done. There's some. Though it is not there, but I'm using it to create, you know, some up and downs here. Just to create a movement, that's it. Let's use a darker value here. Just want to, I think it's good enough. I can increase more value here. So that's it. Very important area left here. So I think I'm done, friends. Remove it, but before it gets done, this extra lines. So, here I should be working a bit. Get the drawing out of it. So I think I'm done. Let's try to remove the tape and see how it occurs. So friends, hoping you have enjoyed the video and learned the tutorial of creating this kind of still life. So if you are new in my channel, again I am reminding you, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell icon to watch more tutorial like this. Thank you friends, and let's start practicing. See you soon again on my next video. Stay tuned. Take care. Bye.